A new report has revealed Adani would have to provide financial assurance of up to $2 billion for the rehabilitation of the Carmichael mine proposed for central Queensland. The Indian miner has postponed its final investment decision on whether to go ahead with the $21 billion coal and rail project.
Adani wants to build Australia's biggest coal mine in the heart of Queensland's Galilee Basin. Lock the Gate Alliance has crunched the numbers on how much it would cost to rehabilitate the land once it's mined. Using the Queensland Government's own calculating method, the activist group says Adani would have to provide initial financial assurance of between $1.5 and $2 billion.
And that would make it the largest financial assurance claim in the state. It's essential that the government gets this right. It's a huge mine. It'll have a huge footprint.
Some industry analysts who oppose the mine say Adani faces a multitude of obstacles before the project can become a reality, including backing from financial institutions. And rehabilitation poses just another hurdle.
I think Adani is going to struggle to find anyone willing to go guarantor on a multi-billion dollar, multi-decade rehabilitation liability.
The Queensland Government has announced reforms to ensure that mining rehabilitation is done progressively and that financial assurance is provided to protect taxpayers from the risk of abandoned mines.
Adani says it will comply with all rehabilitation requirements now or in the future, but there's been no formal decision on proceeding with the project, a touchy subject for Cabinet Ministers.
I'll look at, you know, I covered that topic previously. I've got nothing further to add, I think, today.
Mine rehabilitation expert Dr Gavin Mudd says bigger projects like the Carmichael mine pose a big challenge.
I think this report is a very realistic assessment, and I think the industry and government need to get past the sort of historic practice of generally treating things like bonds and the cost of rehabilitation as very commercially sensitive and therefore held confidential, and start to work in a much more public and transparent manner.
Adani has postponed its final investment decision while Queensland's Cabinet decides whether to offer a royalties discount that could be worth up to $320 million. Louisa Rebgetz, ABC News.